Hello, my name is Reddy8, and for this presentation, I'll be doing lab 1.1 encryption using binary slash byte addition. This will be the text file I'll be working with. First, I'm going to go ahead and look at the histogram for this file. As you can see, the letter A, E, and O seems to be the one that occurs frequently in this text. The letter E is actually the most common one for the English language. I'll be using this information later on for the attack. Now I'm going to go ahead and encrypt this file using byte addition. I'll use the key 1234ABCD. So under this encryption algorithm, the key entered is added character by character or byte by byte to the data to be encrypted. So I'm going to go ahead and encrypt. Now this is the encrypted message. Now I'm going to go ahead and do a ciphertext only attack on this encrypted message. As you can see, it shows us the derived key length is 4. For the most common character that's expected, I'll be entering 20, which will be the value you get when you subtract the hexadecimal value of capital letter E from the hexadecimal value of small letter E, which would be 65 minus 45. I'm going to go ahead and continue. As you can see, CrypTool was able to find the key I originally entered. I'm going to go ahead and decrypt. And as you can see, it took me back to the file I originally encrypted. And the only thing we needed for this attack was to know which letters occur frequently in the text. If the original text is compressed prior to encryption, then it will be hard to draw any conclusion from the frequency distribution. I'll show you what I mean by that. I'm going to go ahead and cancel these. So I'm going to go ahead and compress this file, then encrypt the file. I'm going to use the zip compression. As you can see, the compression rate is 52%. I'm going to go ahead and click OK. Now, this is the compressed file. Compression process not only reduces size of a file, but also alters the frequency of the individual characters, so they no longer reflect the frequency of the characters in the original text. So let's look at the histogram to show you what I mean. As you can see, the characters here are more evenly distributed compared to the one we saw originally first. Now I'm going to go ahead and encrypt the compressed file. I'll use the same key. And then I'm going to go ahead and do a cipher text only attack on the compressed then encrypted file. As you can see, it gave us the incorrect key length, which is 5. Because of that, it's impossible to find the correct key. All right. As you can see, it gave us the wrong key. To check if we can reverse the compressed and then encrypted document to a readable version, I'm going to go ahead and decrypt this file and then uncompress it. I'm going to put the same key I had and then decrypt. And then now we just have a compressed file. Now I'm going to go ahead and unzip this file. And there you go. It brought me back to the original file I was working with. This concludes my presentation for Lab 1.1. Thank you.